morning. Welcome to worship in Hosanna. It is Palm Sunday. It is a joy for us to be together, and it's a delight to see so many faces I haven't seen in months, I guess for some a year. So welcome to worship. I have a few announcements before we continue. The first are there are a number of items you need for worship today. The first is a palm. And if you don't have a palm, raise your palm and an usher. I have had so much. Okay, we need one, a couple. If you don't have a palm, raise your palm and an usher will bring you one of these to wave in celebration. So, and Darlene, two more down here. Okay, good. A couple other things you need that hopefully you'll found in your bulletin is a, right here, Darlene, is a little pamphlet. This is a narrative of our gospel reading today, and there is a part for the congregation to read. It's bolded as people. So if you don't have one of these, raise your hand again and we'll make sure you have one. They were hopefully in all of the bulletins. And the last thing you'll have found in your bulletin is this off-white form. This is how we'll be taking attendance moving forward. So if you would fill this out and then place it in the offering plate on your way out, that way we can celebrate your presence here and also record that. There are a few other announcements in the bulletin. I'd like to lift up, though, the worship services we're providing for this most holy week in our church year. So on page 16 is a list of all of the worship opportunities, both in person and a few that we'll have online as well. So join us this week as we celebrate and remember and grieve and give thanks for the hope that comes from Jesus alone. Let us now stand as we are able and invite you to face the back of the sanctuary. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany, near the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it. If anyone says to you, 'Why are you doing this?' just say this, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately.' They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, 'What are you doing untying the colt?' They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, 'Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest!' Then he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior, Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread their garments and branches along his way. Bless these branches and those who carry them. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross, so that, joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you. Through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Cheered and shouted, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. But the cheers were shallow, and the celebration was short-lived. For in the background, the chief priests, the scribes, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the Herodians were green with envy and red with anger. Today is Palm Sunday, a day of paradox. Today the king rode into the capital on a lowly colt. Today he cried at this royal reception. Today the cheers briefly held back the drumbeats of doom. Today only the Christ candle burns throughout the service.
O God of mercy and might, in the mystery of the passion of your Son, you offer your infinite life to the world. Gather us around the cross of Christ and preserve us until the resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first lesson is from the 50th chapter of Isaiah. The image of the servant of the Lord is one of the notable motifs in Isaiah 40 to 55. Today's reading is a self-description of the mission of the servant. This motif became even more important in the early church for understanding the suffering and death of Jesus. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty. This is the word of the Lord. We'll read Psalm 31, spoken responsively. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. I am the scorn of all my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Lord,
The second lesson is from Philippians, the second chapter. Paul quotes from an early Christian hymn that describes Jesus' death on the cross as the primary model for Christians of obedience and unselfishness. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that in the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
congregation will read in unison the part of the people. It was now 2 days before the Passover and the Feast of Unleavened Bread, and the chief priests and the scribes were seeking how to arrest him by stealth and kill him, for they said,
"Not during the feast, but take it to the people."
And while he was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at a table, a woman came with an alabaster flask of ointment of pure nard, very costly, and she broke the flask and poured it over his head. But there were some who said to themselves indignantly, and they reproached her. But Jesus said,
"Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has done a beautiful thing to me. For you always have the poor with you, and whenever you will, you can do good to them. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for burying. And truly I say to you, wherever the gospel is preached in the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her."
Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. And when they heard it, they were glad and promised to give him money. And he sought an opportunity to betray him. And on the first day of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him,
"Where will you have us go and prepare for you to catch the..."
And he sent two of his disciples and said to them,
"Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the householder, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room? Where am I to eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. There, prepare for us."
And the disciples set out and went to the city and found it as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And when it was evening, he came with the 12. And as they were at the table eating, Jesus said,
"Truly, I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me."
They began to be sorrowful and to say to him one after another, "Is it I?" He said to them,
"It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the dish with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born."
And as they were eating, he took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said,
"Take, this is my body."
And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them,
"This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly, I say to you, I shall not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink of it new in the kingdom of God."
And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to Mount of Olives, and Jesus said to them,
"You will all fall away, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Even though they all fall away, I will not."
And Jesus said to him,
"Truly I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
But he said vehemently,
"If I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And they all said the same, and they went to a place which was called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I pray."
And he took with him Peter and James and John and began to be greatly depressed and troubled. And he said to them,
"My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch."
And going a little farther, he fell on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said,
"Abba, Father, all things are possible to thee. Remove this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what thou wilt.
And he came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter,
Simon, are you asleep? Could you not watch 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak.
And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to answer him. And he came the third time and said to them,
Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand.
And immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with him a crowd with swords and clubs, from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying,
The one I shall kiss is the man. Seize him and lead him away under guard.
And when he came, he went up to him at once and said,
Master.
And he kissed him, and they laid hands on him and seized him. But one of those who stood by drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his ear. And Jesus said to them,
Have you come out as against a robber with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled.
And they all forsook him and fled. And a young man followed him with nothing but a linen cloth around his body, and they seized him. But he left the linen cloth and ran away naked. And they led Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes were assembled. And Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with guards and warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council sought testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none. For more bore false witness against him, and their witnesses did not agree. And some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying,
You heard him say, I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another not made with hands.
Yet even so did their testimony agree, and the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus,
Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?
But he was silent and made no answer. Again, the high priest asked him,
Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed?
And Jesus said,
I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven.
And the high priest tore his garments and said,
Why do we still need witnesses? You have heard his blasphemy. What is your decision?
And they all condemned him as deserving death. And some began to spit on him and to cover his face and to strike him, saying to him, Prophesy. And the guards received him with blows. And as Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the maids of the high priest came, and seeing Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said,
You also were with the Nazarene Jesus.
But he denied it, saying,
I neither know nor understand what you mean.
And he went out into the gateway, and the maid saw him and began again to say to the bystanders,
This man is one of them.
But again he denied it. And after a little while again, the bystanders said to Peter,
One of them. For you are a Galilean.
But he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear,
I do not know this man of whom you speak.
And immediately the cock crowed a second time, and Peter remembered how Jesus had said to him,
Before the cock crows twice, you will deny me 3 times.
And he broke down and wept. And as soon as it was morning, the chief priests with the elders and scribes and the whole council held a consultation, and they bound Jesus and led him away and delivered him to Pilate. And Pilate asked him,
Are you the king of the Jews?
And he answered him,
You have said so.
And the chief priests accused him of many things, and Pilate again asked him,
"Have you no answer to make? See how many charges they bring against you."
But Jesus made no further answer, so that Pilate wondered. Now at the feast he used to release them one prisoner for whom they asked. And among the rebels in prison who had committed murder in the insurrection, there was a man called Barabbas. And the crowd came up and began to ask Pilate to do as he wanted to do for them. And he answered them,
"Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?"
For he perceived that it was out of envy that the chief priests had delivered him up. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release for them Barabbas instead. And Pilate again said to them,
"Then what shall I do with the man whom you call the King of the Jews?"
And they cried out again,
"Crucify him."
And Pilate said to them,
"Why, what evil has he done?"
But they shouted all the more,
"Crucify him."
So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. And the soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is the Praetorium, and they called together the whole battalion, and they clothed him in a purple cloak, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it on him. And they began to salute him,
"Hail, King of the Jews."
And they struck his head with a reed and spat upon him, and they knelt down in homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him, and they led him out to crucify him. And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. And they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull, and they offered him wine mingled with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his garments among them, casting lots for them to decide which each would take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him. And the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying,
"Ah, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross."
So also the chief priests mocked him to one another with the scribes, saying,
"He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross, that we may see and believe."
Those who were crucified with him also reviled him. And when the sixth hour had come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice,
"Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani,"
which means, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders hearing it said, and one ran and, filling a sponge full of vinegar, put it on a reed and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." And Jesus uttered a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. And when the centurion who stood facing him saw that he thus breathed his last, he said,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
I invite you all to stand as you are able. Together, let us confess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit,
Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. In Jesus, you came among us as a suffering servant. Give your church humility. Redeem your people from pride and the certainty that we always know your will. Heal us and empower us to confess Christ crucified. Hear us, O God. In creation, life springs from death. Redeem your creation awaiting resurrection. Restore lost habitats and endangered species. Create new possibilities for areas affected by climate change. Grant relief from natural disasters and nurture new growth. Hear us, O God. Jesus was handed over to the powers of this world. In all nations, instruct the powerful that they would not exploit their power, but maintain justice. Sustain soldiers and guide those who command them, that they serve those in greatest need. Hear us, O God. On the cross, Jesus joined all who feel forsaken. Abide with those who are condemned to death. Defend those who are falsely accused. Console and strengthen those who are mocked or bullied. Accompany all who suffer, especially Diana, Ken, David, Martha, Lyle, Phil, Lou, Laura, and Breck, as well as our homebound members, all unable to worship this weekend, and all family, friends, and even enemies we name now, either out loud or in the silence of our hearts. Grant respite and renewal. Hear us, O God. You called followers to tend to Jesus' body in death. Sustain hospice workers and funeral directors. Bless this congregation's ministries at time of death. Those who plan and lead funerals, those who prepare meals, and all who offer support in grief. Hear us, O God. You inspired the centurion to confess Jesus as your son. We praise you for the faith you have given to people of all places and times. Give us also such faith to trust the promises of baptism and with them to look for the resurrection of the dead. Hear us, O God.
We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
From our pews, let us share Christ's peace with those around us and also with those worshiping with us online.
And we do pray.
Let us stand as we are able.
Faithful God,
you walk beside us in desert places.
And you meet us in our hunger for bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal that we may pass over from death to life in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, whose suffering and death gave salvation to all. You gather your people around the tree of the cross, transforming death into life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. One brief announcement about communion. You will receive communion in your pews. John and I will walk through the pews with the wafers only. Jesus draws the whole world to himself. Come to this meal and be fed. I invite you to stand as you are able. May this body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
You are what God made you to be, created in Christ Jesus for good works, chosen as holy and beloved, free to serve your neighbor. God bless you that you may be a blessing. In the name of the holy and life-giving Trinity, amen. I invite you to turn to page 15 for our closing song, The Old Rugged Cross.
Thank you. Praise be to God.